Hey there, I'm Jen Rice, and I want to talk today about a mineral that keeps popping up literally every subject that I'm going through in my functional medicine fellowship. This mineral just keeps coming up and coming up. And so I thought, you know, I personally didn't take it till, I don't know, maybe 6 or 8 months ago. So I'm thinking there might be quite a few people in my Facebook network who maybe aren't taking it either, or maybe aren't getting the right foods that have it in there. And so today we're talking about magnesium. And you know, what I came across was this study, and it got my attention because the study was on depression, and it was actually an article that talked about, is magnesium the new depression supplement? So basically what they did was, and hey, I see you guys jumping on. I'm glad to have you talking today about really an easy to find, inexpensive supplement that a lot of us don't even know if we need more of, but a lot of us usually do. And so I'm going over this study that I read about in the Townsend letter, which was 126 adults. The mean age was about 52 years old. And they were living in Vermont, and they had been diagnosed with mild to moderate depression. And so they randomly assigned these patients over a course of 6 weeks. They gave them really what I would consider a lower dose of magnesium. It was about 200 and I believe 75 milligrams. And after 6 weeks, they kind of took them through their symptoms to see how they had improved. And basically, about 40% of the people that received the magnesium supplement felt better. And literally all they were taking was this additional magnesium supplement. And it was what I would consider probably a low dose. And so the point of the article was that you really can't wait on a low serum magnesium. So say you go to your primary care doctor, or maybe you also, maybe you visit a functional medicine doctor. You know, when the serum magnesium is low, of course, they're going to say, okay, well, it's time for supplementation, but you really can't wait for that to be apparent, because the intracellular, so inside the cell versus what's outside the cell, has a lot to do with how the cell behaves. And so when they're measuring serum, like the blood, they may not catch a low magnesium level. So it's not harmful to go ahead and take extra magnesium. In fact, we start a lot of patients on about 400 milligrams in the evening. Magnesium can help with a lot of things. So what are some symptoms that you might be magnesium deficient? And there's going to be a few, so hang on with me. So short-term memory loss can be a sign. Emotional ups and downs. Irrational fears. Panic attacks. Anxiety. Depression. Easily angered. Insomnia. Maybe people are, specifically if you're having like early morning awakenings and then can't get back to sleep. Fatigue, muscle twitches and tremors, muscle cramps, constipation. Constipation is a big one that we write magnesium. Well, actually we suggest magnesium because you could just buy it, right? Because the side effect of you taking too much magnesium would be diarrhea. You could tell if you were taking too much of the supplement if you develop diarrhea. So it does help with constipation. Symptoms that you might also be having is like a hyper irritability, excessive perspiration. So if you're, you know, sweating quite a bit, diastolic high blood pressure. So there's the top blood pressure number and the bottom blood pressure number. And if you're having a higher bottom blood pressure number, it could be because you are magnesium deficient. And then if you're having an increased frequency of urination, these are all signs that you could be magnesium depleted. And what's great is I have this. So my doctor I work with is so awesome. She gave me this book that she sent me home with, these like homemade books that she's done from her fellowship that have all of her notes in here. So I feel like I'm getting attached to, you know, her brain as well, which is really cool. And I love being able to pass this information on to not only to myself, but to people out there that may, you know, may want to do some really quick, easy things for your health. So magnesium actually takes part of 300 different enzymatic reactions that go on in our body. So that is a lot of things happening that magnesium takes part in. And it's also critical for ATP, which is like the energy of our cells. So we need magnesium to have our cells create the energy it needs. I also want to share one other study, which I think you might want to hear about, which has to do with PMS. So they did a study where they supplemented women that suffered from PMS with just a lower dose of magnesium, again, like 250 milligrams, for 3 months, and they noted that 34% of those women felt better with their symptoms. Now, are you hearing 80%? Are you hearing 90%? Are you hearing, 75%? No. But magnesium is very inexpensive. It's easy to find. It's easy to implement into your supplements. You can also find it through your foods. And let's go through those foods real quick because I think that could be helpful. So the foods that are high in magnesium are like green leafy vegetables, vegetables in general, nuts, seeds, figs, shrimp. I mean, there's this huge list of magnesium-rich foods, and a lot of times it won't be surprising to hear that these are more like whole foods, foods that are not processed, foods that are closest to their original, how you would find them mostly, in their purest form. So why would anyone have a magnesium deficiency and why do so many people evidently have one? Well, we know that things that we eat and drink can deplete our magnesium, and things in our environment deplete it too. So things that we're drinking that decrease our magnesium are alcohol. So drinking alcohol, eating sugary foods, having, increased coffee amounts, increased colas, those all deplete magnesium. And there's also the herbicides that are used in GMO crops. So these genetically modified crops, there's herbicides that are used that actually will then decrease our magnesium that we're absorbing, right? And so when you're looking for a magnesium supplement, it's important for you to not pick up magnesium oxide because they're saying about only 4% of that supplement is absorbed. So it'd be like, why bother taking it? Because you're not going to really absorb it. And it's just, and especially if you have any absorption issues or GI issues at all, you don't want to be taking something that's just going to kind of go right through. It's sort of like money down the drain, right? So I would say picking up magnesium that is glycinate, threonate, or citrate, and starting with a good starting dose that we usually say is 400 milligrams. That's two tablets in the evening close to bedtime is a good start for you. Now, the range that a lot of people will talk about is anywhere between 400 milligrams and 1,000 milligrams a day. You'll know if you're getting too much magnesium because you'll have diarrhea, right? So I'm not saying, go for gold, but, just so you know, if you develop diarrhea, I would stop it. Hey, Vanessa, awesome. I love seeing you here, and I know you have tons of experience with this. Okay, so PMS and cramping almost not existent. Yeah, so that's why I have to point out the science because I know I have I know for me I like having the science behind it. 32% of people being improved isn't a landslide. But my thought is, well, what if you're one of the 32, then it is a big deal for you, right? So it's sort of like perspective. Like you try it, it doesn't work for you, you really didn't lose anything. You try it and it works for you like it did for you, then that's awesome, right? And it's inexpensive and easy to find. So, like I said, I just wanted to share this today because I've gotten a lot out of, something as simple as adding magnesium to my, I can't tell you for sure if it's helped in things, but I know that my energy is good. I know my anxiety is improved. I had mentioned, so a few months back that I had stopped my antidepressant medication back in, it's been at least 7-8 months now. And I think the supplementation helps with that too, and making sure that I'm getting the essential minerals and vitamins, and also eating, of course, helps with that too. I'm not saying everyone needs to walk away from, this is not like a this is not a platform to say you should walk away from the medication you're taking. It was important for me to see if I could, to see if it, if I really needed it or if I was going to experience symptoms. I've actually been doing really good, so I'm happy about that. So I appreciate you guys being on today. Thanks for being here. Hey, Crystal Bell, awesome to see you. So if you like this content, I do have a business page called Jen Rice International. I also do a monthly challenge. It's a 14-day challenge, Intro to Anti-Inflammatory Lifestyle. We are kicking one off in June. So if you're interested in that, you can always pop over to my page and learn more about that. I appreciate you guys being here today. If you have any questions about magnesium, if you're already taking it and you've seen some, you know, because my science that I shared earlier wasn't landslide science, you know, but if it's been helping you, I'd love to hear any feedback on that. It certainly will help other people who watch this. And if you think someone might benefit from hearing this message, you can go ahead and share that. I'd appreciate it. Thank you guys. Have a great, great day.